Just with respect to the fact that Section 11 is very clear when they are making an arrest. Unfortunately, there is no arrest yet here. And then one, they use the child. They use Insignia. Sir, I just want to point out, sir, that the allowing persons who are not police to use police insignia is a violation of Article 179 of the Revised Penal Code. Plus, a second thing, sir, is the fact that they use a child, a minor, to use that. That is, again, child abuse. I just want to point out that to the
court. Yeah, thank you. General Turi, bakit gumamit ng minor? Kung digging ang purpose nyo doon, mag-hukay, bakit parang babae ba yun? Parang babae yung lalaki ba yun? Minor, bakit kayo gumamit ng minor?
Your Honor, I do believe at this point in time na wala namang nag-establish na minor. Those are all allegations. And I can categorically say na walang minor doon, sir. Baka mukhang bata lang.
Mukhang bata, pero...
Mukhang bata lang, but really...
For the record.
For the record, sir, none.
For the record, pinasok mo yun for the purpose of digging or
yes,
for the purpose of... Baka mamaya ang apprehension nila is gagamitin na naman ninyo doon sa loob na parang victim of trafficking, sir, na naman.
Of course not, sir.
The purpose, yung apprehension nila, ha? Pero for the record,
the instruments indicate that our targets could be 4 meters below ground. And I believe that we need experts on this matter, especially on digging this hole, because we want to ensure that these people have the experience. That's not something that the police does every day. So who are the people who knows and has the experience on digging? Minero, sir.
So with that explanation of yours, it is the impression of this committee that you admit that you really did a digging below the GMC.
Yes, sir. It's part of our presentation later on, sir. And just a presentation, sir.
Kaya nga, in-admit mo.
Yes, sir.
Kala ko hindi mo i-admit. I am ready to set you in contempt kung hindi
yes,
mo i-admit. Ako mismo, you have no way to lie before me because ako mismo, pinuntahan ko kanina sa inspection kanina, hinukay namin doon, very... press pa yung simento na ginawa at nung natanggal yung simento, yung mga kabilya na nilagay doon, hindi kabilya na construction na related ba kabilya, kundi kung saan saan lang napulot na kabilya yon, and yung lupa is very loose. But then, that's immaterial anymore to discuss about that because you admit that you did the digging below that the basement of GMC
Yes, sir.
Building.
Yes, sir. I have okay. I have lots of bosses.
Okay.
And they can testify on the kind of destruction that Feast of Carat First Class Bato de la Rosa, sir, can come to them if they violate the rules, sir. So I really will not dare to do that and lie to you.
Yeah, be sure, because it pains me to cite you in contempt if I need to do that because you are the regional director of this particular police regional office of this region. And that would be a slap on the PNP kapag ang kanilang boss ay na-cite in contempt ng isang committee hearing because of lying and testifying falsely before the committee.
Yes, sir.
I hate to do that.
Yes, sir.
Please make sure that you don't lie to this committee.
It will be part of the presentation, sir. And even the future diggings is included there, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Mr. Chair.
Meron pa yung future digging?
Mr. Chair.
It's included in the presentation, sir.
Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair.
Dali, ha? Unahin ko muna si Jason San. Nauna nag-kwan.
Salamat po.
Yeah.
I just want to know from the chair whether the digging was in accordance with the law. I'd like to ask, therefore, the chair to ask the PNP whether they secured a digging permit because the structural integrity of the building, which carried preschool, kindergarten, elementary students, high school students, college students, postgraduate, nanganganib po ang buhay nila. doon sa integrity ng gusali kung ito ay magkakaroon ng konting pag-inog ng mundo. Huwag sabihin siya pa, huwag muli inog taon, asa man po nito ng mga batang gagmay, nawa magit sila ibang kaagan, anang maumpang itabo. Where did they secure a permit from the building official of the city, Mr. Chair?
General Torre.
Sir,
the question is, did you secure a digging permit from the building officials of the city of Davao or any permit from DNR for that matter? Before
no,
you do that?
No, sir.
No?
No, sir.
Okay.
Sir.
Mr. Thank Chair. You for that answer.
Mr. Chair, may I
have... So, it's noted by this committee that he did not secure any permit from any pertinent and competent government agency that is regulating the digging operations.
Mr. Chair.
Go ahead, Attorney Fuentes.
Thank you, sir. Sir, considering that he hired civilians, may we know the names of the civilians that he hired for the digging, sir?
So, you should understand that their property was negatively impacted by the digging operations. That's why they are looking for the names of those people responsible in the digging. So, since ikaw ang nag-recruit noon, please give us the name. Submit Mr. to this committee.
Mr. Chair? Okay? Yes, Mr. Chair, we will...
Ilan yon? Ilan? Ilan yon?
I have lost track, maybe around 7 or 6.
7.
Mr. Chair. But we will provide it to you and just consult my...
Please, before this hearing ends, please submit to this committee.
But I would like to state for the record, Your Honor, that everything that they did is under my responsibility. I take full responsibility for their actions.
You are the commander. You should assume all responsibility.
Yes, sir.
Very good. Assume all the responsibility. You are the commander.
Mr. Chair.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Yes. Building official of Davao City.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon.
Tas, tung yani. Right.
Good afternoon, Mr. Chair. May I ask General Torre if during the time of excavation and all of the construction activities done in the basement, was there a professional engineer architect supervising over the work being done?
Thank you. You heard the question, please answer.
Yes, sir. We have structural engineers and...
Sino? Regional engineering yes, sir. Service mo?
We have one civil, one architect, and one structural engineer, sir. I'll cover everything in the presentation, sir.
Ano doon sa presentation mo?
Sir.
Meron silang engineer.
That question came about because earlier when General Torre was talking, he said, they hired the experts for digging, which were yung mga minero. In my opinion, that's hindi siguro tama yung eksperto natin doon is yung minero. In if yung safety, yung like it was mentioned earlier in the rules of court, yung breaking in, Your Honor, humingi kasi ako ng opinion from NBCDO, National Building Code Development Office, yung executive officer nila. I asked if yung breaking in doon will is applicable to the breaking of building or demolition of any part thereof. According to the commissioner, ang sabi niya sa akin is, yung breaking in can apply to breaking of a door or a window to access a building. However, yung act of demolition or breaking structural parts of a building is a regulated activity and it should need a permit or order from the court na will order the perhaps the building official to give assistance to our whoever is undertaking the job. That's all, Mr. Chair. Thank
noted,
you.
Noted. Sino yun? Sino yung tinanong mo?
Si Attorney Belderol, sir.
Sino siya?
National Building Code Development Office. I think he is the executive director or Okay. Currently, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. Chair.
Well noted. Well noted.
Mr. Chair, in connection with this, considering that I am the chairman of the board of the Jose Maria College Foundation Incorporated, if ever there is going to be any structural damage to the building of JMC, is the police willing to pay for the damages due to the digging that they caused?
I presume they have to pay kung mayroong court order ordering them to pay whatever damages that they have done. Am I correct, General Torre?
Yes, sir. Definitely, sir.
Mr. Chair. So,
bayaran nila. Kung you file the corresponding case and the decision na korte, bayaran natin sa PNP.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Mr. Chair. A few days ago, General Torre was in a press con and he very clearly stated that there was no digging. He denied that he nagdig ang PNP, and he said that excavation didn't exist, and he also said that those were just Photoshop pictures.
Okay. But that statement was not given before this committee.
Yes.
Before you.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Before the public. Before the public.
He said it in a press con. So, Mr. Chair, this again is the problem, that he maybe can tell the truth to you, but once you leave...
For fear of
yes.
becoming...
Yes.
Being cited in contempt.
Yes.
Because I am serious in my job. I don't care kung sino man, basta if you testify falsely before this committee, I have to cite you in contempt.
Yes, Mr. Chair, but unfortunately not all of us are senators, and the Filipino people are not senators, and he blatantly lied to the Filipino people about it.
Will you please respond, General Torre? Why did you lie before the Filipino people that you did not do such digging?
Sir, masyado tayong nasa sidetrack. Hindi ko maintindihan, sir, ang sinasabi ni Dr. Badoy.
Kung
simple. Kailang ginawa, sir, I did not
napaka do that. Napakasimple lang.
I did not do that, sir.
Hindi ka?
I did not do that and I did not say that.
If you can
present to me the video, maybe I can review it. But right now, there's no video presented except for the statement of Dr. Badoy, who is delaying the presentation of Attorney Torreon.
Okay. Can you please give me that video?
Mr. Chair, he had a press con 2 days ago, and he even challenged Attorney Torreon to prove it.
Ang sabi kasi niya sa press con, he has to, that's the allegation of Attorney Torreon, and he should prove it in court, and he should prove it, walang in court, he should prove it because madali, nasa Photoshop naman yan. Parang Photoshop na yan. Yun po, sabi niya.
Sige, last response before we proceed. Para,
Sometimes I'm really thinking that they don't want to proceed with their presentation. But I think that sidetracks the issue. Because as to the moment, sir, Dr. Badoy is making an allegation, sir.
This committee
does
not believe that it hijacks the issue.
Okay,
that,
sir.
That issue is very important and very relevant in this investigation.
So the answer, sir, is no. I did not say things that that Dr. Badoy is attributing to me.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Later on, Dr. Badoy,
we're retrieving the press con, Mr. Chair, where he blatantly and clearly stated that there was no excavation and that those were just Photoshop photos.
Okay. Noted. Kung meron kayong recordings on, palabas natin. Please continue.
One last question regarding sa excavation. Bakit po minadali nila, tinabunan kaagad para hindi po nyo makita ng committee po ninyo? Madali po yun, sir. Overnight po, sir. Napakabilis po, natabunan kaagad. Kung sabi niya, accountable siya dun sa paghuhukay.
Okay. Let's be frank about it. Bakit niyo tinabunan kaagad?
Sir, that will be covered my presentation, sir. Even before, without even the okay, silent hearing, we will cover it, sir.
We'll wait for your presentation.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you. Continue.
So, after that, Your Honor, though we have strong reservations to the legal opinion of our respected government officers, Your Honor, and I am really concerned with the legal opinions that they expressed, no? Knowing that they represent the Department of Justice. But anyway, we will continue, Your Honor. At 9 p.m. again, Your Honor, we already covered that. This is on August 29. Unidentified men again were entering, and some had very long haircuts, no? And one was with beard and escorted by the PNP to the compound. But that's covered already. So let's go to August 30, Honor, at 9 a.m., no? The police, through PRO 11 Logistics Office, once again attempted to cart away. They wanted to get the KOJC fire truck, no? Good that the lawyer was present there, and they would have been able to seize the fire truck, Your Honor. And the respondents here placed their own battery in order to sneak away the fire truck. Yeah. And at 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. on August 30, there were two PNP choppers. And General Torre was clearly on board because he was shown, Your Honor, some cameras had strong power to capture who, even if they are meters away. And I think General Torre admitted that he was on board the chopper, no? And but the problem is that it hovered too low, and we had reasons to believe that it was purposive, Your Honor, because of the solar panel installed at the top of the building. We had reasons to believe that they were thinking that the solar panels were supplying electricity to the imaginary bunker that they have made the public believe is existing, but despite 14 days, they have not been able to locate. What actually transpired is that our solar panels, Your Honor.
Excuse me. General Torre, did you intentionally instruct the pilot of the chopper to go low so that in order to destroy that solar panels?
No, sir. For that, sir, we deeply apologize, and we are willing to pay the KOJC regarding the solar panel if we really cause that the destruction of that panel.
Thank you.
Because that will be a very dangerous maneuver, yeah, for us. Because
kayo ang pasahero diyan, delikado pag,
yes, sir.
Pag lumipad yung solar panel, tumama doon sa helicopter ninyo.
Of course, sir.
Sabog kayo.
Yes, sir. Obviously.
Please
continue.
So the word of General Torre would bind the PNP that they will pay, Your Honor.
Yes, yes, they will pay.
Thank
they
you. Thank pay. You, Your Honor. So proceeding from that, Your Honor, this also, Your Honor, is very concerning because one alleged policeman, Your Honor, was dressed as a policeman, using police uniform, but it turned out to be a former member of the KOJC who testified during the Senate investigation, Your Honor. And his name is Edward Masayon, but he was made to wear as if his last name was Esclito. And this is really concerning, Your Honor, because the police is allowing certain members, former members, disgruntled members who testified even against the accused, as one of their alleged policemen. May we ask General Torre about this, Your Honor?
You answer the question.
What is their issue, sir?
Itong former member ng KOJC na pinasuot niyo ng uniforme at pinapasok doon sa loob.
Are they admitting, sir, that Edward Masayon is a former member of the KOJC?
Huh?
Are they admitting that Edward Masayon is a former member of the KOJC?
It's written there, sir.
Oh, yeah.
So
they admit
that bolsters our allegation that we have credible informants regarding the presence of Pastor Apollo Quiboloy.
So meaning yung si Masayon ang source of information mo?
One of the many.
One. Kailan ito tiniwalag ito from QJC? Kailan ito?